Vitamin D is so important to keep our body healthy. It can prevent cardiovascular disease. It keeps our bones strong. It helps build our immune system. It fights cancer. It works with other hormones, to just name a few. Although the big problem is that we don't spend time in the sun like we did when we were younger. So therefore, we're not getting enough vitamin D. There's no doubt that vitamin D deficiency is one of the largest epidemics in the world today. So it's vitamin D3 we're talking about, cholecalciferol. Unfortunately, it's so hard to get enough of it from our diet, from our foods. And supplementation is the best way to get it. Now, the recommended daily allowance is only 600 to 800 IUs. To me, that's not enough. There are other studies that say between 1500 and 2000, as well as up to 4000 IUs a day. Now, vitamin D is fat soluble. That means it gets stored in the liver as well as the fat cells. And in order for your body to absorb that vitamin D, there must be fat in your diet. So if you're taking your vitamin D on an empty stomach or with juice where there's no fat, you're going to lose that absorption. You must take it with a meal because most meals were going to have fat. Now you can take it with avocado, olive oil, or any other kind of fat and you will still get great results. Several years back, I had my vitamin D levels checked with a doctor. My levels were very low. I started taking 5,000 IUs of vitamin D for a long, long time. And my levels still never came up as high as where they should have been. That means we all have different types of metabolisms. It could be genetics, your age, your health condition, even conditions like celiac disease or Crohn's disease or intestinal problems that can be preventing the absorption of vitamin D. Now, I simply want you to understand the body's circadian rhythm. This is what controls our sleep-wake cycle, and it plays a role in sleep due to how the body and brain responds to darkness, which is when most humans feel tired and tend to sleep. As darkness sets in, the body's biological clock instructs the cells to slow down. We should look at vitamin D as an indication of daylight or bright morning or afternoon sun, emanating UV rays. If getting sunlight tells our body it's daytime, perhaps taking vitamin D sends a similar message, as this will keep our body on that normal circadian rhythm schedule. So again, taking your vitamin D with a meal in the morning or early afternoon is best for you. And if you take vitamin D at night, this can decrease melatonin. And that's the hormone that helps control your sleep and wake cycles by naturally rising in the mid to late evening. So the worst times to take your vitamin D, if you're taking it without fat, without a meal, or you're just taking it with water, which is no good, or you're taking it too late at night, which inhibits the secretion from the pineal gland in the brain, that melatonin, because that melatonin is what's gonna give you a good night's sleep. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please share it with your friends and family. Leave your comments below because there will be many. And most important, make it a great day. I'm Dr. Alan Mandel.